Garbage patches the size of Texas have been discovered in the ocean. And now researchers have discovered our Great Lakes are filling up with plastic faster than previously thought. 13 ABC meteorologist Ross Ellett showing you tonight how weather technology is tracking the swarms of plastic and what we can do to protect this tremendous natural resource in our community.
Meteorologists use computer models to track storms, wind, and even waves, but now you can add plastic to that list as well. But that same technology could also help volunteers get the trash out of the water.
Clogged by trash.
It's bizarre the things you'll find in a stream. It blows your mind, honestly.
And it was just so, like, beautiful, and now you just have trash everywhere.
Little by little, garbage is piling up along our creeks and streams.
We find a lot of food wrappers, a lot of cigarette butts, plastic and bottles.
And all of it will make it to Lake Erie unless someone does something.
There's nothing quite like just being here and being able to see the impact you're making.
Partners for Clean Streams is an organization made up of young volunteers picking up trash along local streams and rivers. In just an hour and a half one Saturday morning, this group picked up nearly 8 full bags of trash weighing 100 pounds.
Volunteer groups like this will pick up 25,000 pounds of trash every single year. The problem is another 5 million pounds of plastic finds its way into Lake Erie. Now researchers are finding a better way of tracking that plastic using computer models, and that'll help cleanup crews get a better idea of how to get that plastic out of the water.
You talk about 22 million pounds a year entering the Great Lakes, and it makes you think.
Matthew Hoffman is an assistant professor of mathematical sciences at Rochester Institute of Technology, and he's been tracking Lake Erie plastic for the past 6 years.
The larger stuff was all pretty clearly coming from bottles and bags and things like that.
Hoffman's study estimates 5 million pounds of plastic is getting into Lake Erie each year. To put that in perspective, that's about 335 million plastic bags, or about 5.3 million 2-liter bottles. If you filled the glass bowl with all that loose plastic, it would come out to about 40 feet deep, which is just about the height of the top of the goalpost.
It's pretty clear that once the plastic is in the environment, it's being ingested by wildlife.
We found birds entangled in fishing line, and we found fish with a walleye actually with his head stuck through a beverage top. So it's impacting not only us, but everything else that lives here.
There's also some research showing this plastic could lower the quality of our drinking water.
All of this debris eventually breaks down in the water, and those chemicals leach out.
Hoffman hopes the study will help bring more awareness to the problem and also help volunteers track the trash as it washes ashore.
If you want to target a specific area to be cleaner, where you actually have to regulate.
While it is becoming clear how big the plastic problem is on the Great Lakes, there's also some positive news blooming this spring. Volunteer numbers are up, and most of those that are picking up trash today will be the leaders of tomorrow.
I'm looking forward to seeing what we can end up doing someday.
So far, all the research focuses on the water surface, but the next phase of the study will investigate how much plastic could be at the bottom of Lake Erie. Reporting, Ross Sellett, 13 ABC Action News.